Hello everyone, welcome to today's video on PMBOK 7th series. Today we're going to talk about project measurement performance domain. So far we have seen videos on stakeholder, team performance, development approach, planning performance, project work performance, and delivery performance domains. Today we're going to discuss on measurement performance. What are the activities and functions that are associated with this particular domain is the way you want to assess the project performance and the appropriate actions you want to take to maintain the acceptable performance. These are the main functions and activity you would like to address in this particular domain. What are the desired outcomes of this measurement domain is, as a project manager, you need to provide a reliable understanding of the status of the project. The stakeholder who are receiving the status of the project should understand what is in it for them and what is the real status, what is the reality, and what is the baseline one, what are the variances. So you need to give a very good understanding about the current progress and what is left over, when it can be completed, right? So all the risks and issues and everything. The second desired outcome is the actionable data to facilitate the decision making. So what are the status report? Along with that, you can say that, you know, these are the actions we identified for implementation along with the ownership, with the ETA in it, all right? The third desired outcome is timely and appropriate actions, right? So it's not about only actionable data. Based on the data, the insights and everything, are you defining the actions in a timely manner and with a light ownership? Right, and the final desired outcome is achieving the targets and generating the business value by making informed and timely decisions based on the reliable forecast and evaluations. So based on the reliable status reports and based on the reliable forecast from the status report, are you taking a timely and informed decision to achieve the project objectives and business benefits, right? All four are very, very important desired outcomes. Now we look at, you know, what are the key terms we need to understand this domain. First one is the metric. A metric is a description of the project attribute or a product attribute and how to measure it, right? A defect containment is one metric. How do you measure it? You need to measure your internal defects and you need to measure your customer defects. And you understand what is a leakage and what is being contained, right? So you have the description of the, you know, product attribute or a project attribute and know how to measure it. What is baseline? The baseline is the approved version of the work product. It can be a schedule, it can be a cost, it can be a budget. You can baseline the budget, you can baseline your schedule, which is used as a basis for comparing to the actual results. So compared to baseline schedule, what is my actual schedule now? Compared to baseline budget, what is my actual budget? I mean, actual cost now, right? The third key term is a dashboard. The dashboard is a set of charts and graphs showing progress or performance against important measures of the project. So now we look at the functions associated with measurement performance domain. The first function is establishing effective measures. So you need to establish your key performance indicator. What are my KPIs of this project and product? There are two types of KPIs. One is leading indicators, the other one is lagging indicators. Leading indicators will give you an idea like the trending of the progress of the project. The burn down chart, it's an example of leading indicator. It will tell you that is the team is progressing as desired manner, as committed for the sprint group. The lagging indicator will give you the plan versus actual deviation, the variances, schedule variance and cost variances, right? So leading indicators, it's kind of a preventive measures which will give you an indication on the risk of, you know, not meeting the business outcomes or not meeting the project deliverables, right? It will give an indication so that you can take some preventive measures and you can correct it, and then you can still go on with time with the budget, you can complete that. The lagging indicators is the postmortem metrics where, you know, you complete the process and see what's measured, do a root cause analysis and come back and redo it. Right? So you need to have a combination of both leading indicators and lagging indicators, and you have to take appropriate actions to it. Right? See, another way of establishing effectiveness is using the SMART metrics. So whatever metrics we're defining, you should follow a SMART rule. SMART stands for specific, meaningful, achievable, relevant, and time bound. So metrics should be specifically, you should talk about particular parameter of product or project. It should be meaningful, it should be connected to a business case or business outcome. It should be achievable, right? So you should know what is the team skill set, you should know how many people we have, and you need to understand what is the domain we are in. So whether it is achieved based on the previous history data and, you know, organization asset information, you can see that, you know, is this organization, this particular deliverable can be achieved with this kind of setup, and how relevant and time bound. So metrics should be relevant to your project deliverables. It should be relevant to your business benefits. You don't want to track a metric which is not relevant to you. It is going to be a pitfall. So similarly, it should be time bound. You should be able to, you know, put a timeliness to it so that you can see that, you know, in terms of time and progress, you can see that. Right? So now we look at the another next function is what to measure. There are different types of metrics, different category of metrics you can look at it. Let's start with deliverable metrics. The metrics related to the project deliverables. To ensure the quality of the deliverable, to ensure the performance of the deliverables. Right? The information on defects or bugs, like defect containment, defect leakage. Right? Cost of quality. So those are the deliverable metrics on defects. Measures of performance, right? If you look at example of a laptop or smartphone, right, you can have a lot of performance parameters like weight, you know, its screen size, right, its, you know, scalability, viewability, you can do that, right? And technical performance measures, right? How technically, you know, optimized this particular, you know, product. In a software scenario, you can talk about, you know, what is the loading time for a particular website, right? That's one of the performance measures. What is the, you know, query power? How fast this application can return the results, right? You are booking a railway ticket, you are booking for searching for certain information. How fast it brings the, how fast it brings the results to you, right? That's a technical performance. So these are related to all metrics related to deliverables. And there is a metrics on delivery as such, right? WAP progress, right? Understanding work in progress items, right? You can measure a lead time, the time between the project or the activity has been taken to the completion, right? Moment you get the, if you log the time, moment you get the order from customer and finally you deliver to customer, the difference is called lead time. Lesser the lead time, you know, more the productivity. Cycle time, right? The time duration between the when you start the activity and then complete the activity. Queue size. You need to understand what is the rate of arrival and what is the rate of completion. You can have optimized number on, you know, queue size. Batch size. Batch size is on throughput, or, you know, it is about the velocity, or, you know, number of items you are completing within the duration of time and the process efficiency. Right? You need to understand that, you know, it is also called, you know, workflow efficiency. Right? You need to understand the time spent on valid activities and non-valid activities, compare it, and then you can understand how efficient is the process. Right? Another set of metrics is baseline performance metrics, start and finish date, schedule, effort and duration. Right? You can baseline your planned effort and duration for a particular activity or particular phase of a life cycle. Schedule variance, right? So simple, planned versus actual. Schedule performance index, actual performance, sorry, actual schedule divided by the planned schedule. It should be always greater than one. That means you are ahead of the schedule, right? Future completion rate or story completion rate. Cost variance, difference between the budgeted cost and actual cost. Cost performance index, the ratio between the budgeted cost and actual cost. And resource metrics, resource utilization variance, right? How many resources we planned in terms of capacity utilization? What is my capacity utilization for a particular sprint? What is my capacity utilization for a particular phase of the project, right? So, are you maintaining 80 to 90% of utilization? So, variation, the variance is less than 10% reduction. Cost variance in resourcing. Right? What is the budget for, you know, human resources, and what is the actual resources we are using? What is the variance between that? Then business value related metrics, cost benefit ratio, right? Understanding, are we getting the expected benefit from the cost we are incurring for that? Business benefit, you know, planned versus actual. So quantified business outcomes, you know, and we can, whatever planned as part of the project outcomes, and we can measure the actuals in terms of business outcomes. Return on investment. Right, the rate of return in which you invested money, what is the rate of return you are getting year on year or month on month or something? Net present value. Net present value is one of the, you know, accurate metrics in terms of identifying the current value of money and stakeholder metrics to understand the happiness and relevance of stakeholders. Right, so net promoter score is the quite famous metric to understand how many people or how many customers, you know, really want to recommend our product. Right, it just gives an indication of the loyalty, customer loyalty. Mood chart of the different stakeholders. How is that in a mood chart, on a daily basis, how the stakeholders are feeling. Morale and turnover. So we can understand the morale of the team members and the turnover. So more the turnover, lesser the morale. Right? And forecast related metrics. Right? These are the metrics, you know, which will help you to forecast. Estimate to complete, right? The additional budget you need to complete, comparing your actual cost and, you know, budgeted cost and there are cost performing index or schedule performance index, you can estimate to complete. What is for the completing the rest of the portion, how much time is going, how more time is going to take, or how much of cost is, additional cost is going to take. That's called estimate to complete, right? Estimate at completion. Estimate at completion is, right, what is the total actual, you know, budget is going to take, right? You know what is, you know, budget, total initial budget, you know that. Now we know what is the actual cost. Then based on the cost performance index, you can understand how much of, you know, additional, you know, cost you're going to incur. Then you can add actual cost with new proposed additional budget, and that you become estimate at completion. The variable at completion is the difference between the budget as completion minus estimated completion. So it should be always positive. right? And the regression analysis and throughput analysis. A regression analysis in which you can do an analysis between a couple of variables and then understand that how it is correlated to each other, right? And then try to change one of the variables and see that, you know, understand the root cause analysis. Throughput analysis is, you know, in terms of velocity or in terms of throughput of, you know, total number of items you are completing within the batch, and you try to optimize that, you know, is the throughput is matching the customer expectations. Is my average velocity or average, you know, lead time or cycle time, does it match the customer expectation, right? That's all. These are the forecast, you can, you know, predictable things you can do that. Right, the next function of measurement performance domain is how we present the information. There are a number of ways and you can present the information. Generally, most of the organization follow the dashboard. This is the one of the examples of dashboard. Talks about, you know, whether all the activities are, you know, green, red, or, you know, yellow, right? It talks about the high level information of the project, executive sponsor, started and date, and it will talk about, you know, current risks and key issues as well. It's a simple dashboard to help you understand how is the progress is of project is progressing compared to its baseline, you know, it is going red and green or, you know, according to that. Right, there's another way of presenting information using visual radiators. The burn down chart and burn up chart is, you know, one of the visual radiators is used in adaptive and agile methods. Right, so every agile team or, you know, scrum team, they will use a burn down chart. You know, they will use it in a daily stand up as well as in our retrospectives. Right, so you can understand, you know, along with that, you can put a risk also in that, you know, radiator. Kanban board, right, visual controls. Kanban board is one other example of presenting information. So each column represents one of the states of your work, you know, work item. So from ready and it goes to development unit test, development test, system test, and done, right? So this is how it goes. Right, this is kind of, you know, release, you know, release start actually. So how many story points are done, what is the expected rate, and what is the actual rate is at which the story points are getting completed. Right, these are the some of the examples of visual controls. And let's understand what are the measurement pitfalls, right? The first one is Hawthorne effect. Hawthorne effect is nothing but, you know, every measure will impact the behavior of the human team members, right? So the metric you are choosing should not be, you know, threatening, or should not be changing the behavior, or people should not get into a, you know, safety net or something. So it should not create a Hawthorne effect. It should help the people to rightly measure the progress, rightly understand, you know, that's where, you know, to avoid Hawthorne effect, you need to compare your metrics are in line with the business outcomes, right? So vanity metrics, you know, it is a metric which is, you know, it's not providing any good information for you. You know, it will be tracked for sake of tracking it, and it will not give any benefit or any relation to the business outcomes. Right, so for example, the number of page views of a website, you know, will not help you out. Instead of, if we measure that, you know, how many new views are coming to the website, that will give you a good metric. Demoralization. So some of the metrics, you know, if we do that in, you know, our productivity metrics, like, you know, the persons are, you know, how much time they're spending in office, or they're spending 9 hours, 15 minutes, or something like that, you know, if you start measuring, so those metrics are demoralizing metrics, which is not even needed for you. That shows, you know, you are distressed with the employees. Misusing the metrics, right? Possibility of misusing it, that, you know, you can, you know, put some statements that say that, you know, the project is running in, you know, delayed schedule and over budget or something. So you should not, you know, create a bias. Right, it does not mean that, you know, over, you know, delay schedule is going to result in, you know, over budgeting or something, right? So you cannot create unnecessary metrics and you misuse it for some other reasons. These are the some of the pitfalls of measurement. You need to be very very keen to understand what are the relevant metrics for the company, relevant metrics for the project and health of the project, and you have to put appropriate metrics. No, you can go with a very minimum, you know, KPIs, top 5 items, and then you can track that items to success of the project and business outcomes, right? So this is another function of, you know, measuring performance domain, is how to troubleshoot the performance, right? So this blue color is showing the planned S-curve, and then the pink or orange curve shows that, you know, 10% upper limit, and the green color shows that 20% lower limit, right? And you track the actuals, right? So the orange and greens are tolerances, and the blue color is, you know, the violet color is a planned one, your actual is all in blue color, right? If you look at this point, you know, these actuals are going beyond the tolerances. So this is how you can troubleshoot that, you know, how, you know, even you can use the control charts for your projects. So control chart will give you lower, you know, lower control limit and upper control limit. Whether these parameters and metrics are, you know, in line with, you know, or it's not going beyond of lower and upper control limits. That's your tolerances. So this is an indication to troubleshoot your, you know, performance, right? So final function of measurement domain is, you know, growing and improving. So you need to allow team to learn. So your metric system should allow the team to learn and progress, right? Your metric system should facilitate the decision. You should improve the product and project performance. You should not degrade it. You should help and avoid an issue, right? You should prevent the performance deterioration, right? Your leading indicators will prevent, right? Your lagging indicators will improve the product and project performance. It will facilitate the decision. The forecast will facilitate the decision, right? So this is how, you know, you can use the different types of metrics for team's growth and improvement, right? So we come to a final slide of our presentation, which is how do we check the outcomes. So we discussed about 4 desirable outcomes. How I'm going to check that, you know, this effective execution is there and we are going to get the desired outcomes, right? So the audit measurements and reports demonstrate the data is reliable, right? So reliable understanding of the status of the project is with the reliable data. So if you are producing a reliable data, then understanding of the status of the project will be reliable, right? And producing actionable data, right? How can I check that, you know, data we are producing is, you know, actionable, which is helping the decision making, right? So measurements indicate whether the project is performance expected or if there is a variances, right? So you can compare the baseline versus actuals and see the indication that, you know, what is the variance, is positive or negative. You can accordingly take the decision, right? The measurement should provide a leading indicators or the current status leads to timely decision and action. So you need to have the leading indicators as well as the lagging indicators to help you take the timely decision actions, right? The final one is comparing the actual performance to the planned performance and evaluating the business documents will show that, you know, likelihood of achieving the intended value of the project, right? We want to check, is my project is achieving the target? It is generating a right set of business value, is being informed in the project charter kind of documents. So how do I do that? You know, reviewing my past forecast, current performance, right? It's demonstrating if previous forecasts reflect the present correctly. And you can compare actuals and plan, and you can evaluate business document. So we'll show the likelihood of achieving the intended value from the project. Right, so with that, we have come to a conclusion of this particular session. So thanks for listening. Please share your comments and tell the new topics you want to cover as part of project management and agile methodologies. I'll be happy to create videos for you. So see you then. Until I meet you in next videos, thank you very much. Bye bye.